So far, this is what I got. This is what it looks like.
Defendant Carla Burwright says she took her child to the plaintiff's in-home daycare, but she pulled him out after she learned that the plaintiff's son, who lived in the home, was a registered sex offender.
What happened with the child?
My son's father died last November, and he was just in recovery, and he was in therapy, and he was getting better and better and better. Then all of a sudden, towards the end, my son started coming home crying and screaming. My son doesn't really speak that much.
Okay, so you don't know why he's crying. All she wants is the money that she earned by keeping your child. Judgment for the plaintiff. Have a good day.
Dated off and on for 10 years, but they broke up while the defendant was in prison. Then they reconciled once he got out, until other women started calling her, saying the defendant was having sex with them. Paula is suing her ex-boyfriend for unpaid tickets. Defendant Robert Ross says when he went to prison, Paula started seeing another man immediately, which hurt him. Robert claims when he was released, he started seeing other women.
Let's turn that down. Anyway, this is all I got so far. This is what it looks like.
Back and forth together over 10 years. Due to him, in and out of jail for the dealing of drugs and possession. 2005, Robert went to jail. And he stated, asked me when I wait, and I told him I will. At that time, I told him, no, I had a change of mind. When he called, I had a change of mind. And
how long after did you have a change of mind?
How long after
telling him you'll wait?
Maybe 6 months.
Okay. What made you change your mind?
I don't know. I just got tired of him going in and out of jail.
Okay. How many times had it changed?
Oh, several times. He called and I told him I was in a relationship and I think he was seeking revenge. 2013, we got back together. I got back with
There you go. I'm done.